This is an auto-narrated audiobook generated by Google. The Poona Pact, a turning point in India's social and political history. By Namaskar Books. Introduction. The Poona Pact, signed on September 24, 1932, was a landmark agreement between Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, representing the depressed classes, scheduled castes, and Mahatma Gandhi, representing the upper caste Hindu leaders. This historic pact was concluded in the Yerwada Central Jail in Pune, India, where Gandhi was undergoing a fast unto death to protest against the British Prime Minister Ramsay MacDonald's communal award. The communal award had proposed separate electorates for the depressed classes, a move that Gandhi vehemently opposed, fearing it would further fragment the Hindu community. Ambedkar, on the other hand, saw the separate electorates as essential for ensuring political representation and safeguarding the interests of the oppressed classes. The agreement was a compromise, where Gandhi's concerns about the division of the Hindu community were addressed by replacing separate electorates with reserved seats in the general electorate. This meant that the depressed classes would have reserved seats but would vote as part of the general electorate, thereby ensuring their political representation while maintaining the unity of the Hindu vote. The Poona Pact marked a crucial moment in India's struggle for social justice, bridging a significant gap between the demands of the depressed classes and the concerns of the broader Indian nationalist movement. The Poona Pact is significant for several reasons. Firstly, it underscored the importance of negotiation and compromise in the face of conflicting ideologies. Gandhi's commitment to the unity of the Hindu community and Ambedkar's determination to secure political representation for the oppressed classes came into direct conflict, but the pact demonstrated the potential for reconciliation and mutual understanding. Secondly, the pact laid the foundation for the reservation system in India, which continues to be a cornerstone of Indian affirmative action policies. By agreeing to reserve seats in the legislative bodies, the Poona Pact set a precedent for future policies aimed at ensuring fair representation of marginalized communities in political, educational, and employment sectors. This system has played a critical role in promoting social justice and mitigating the historical injustices faced by the depressed classes. Thirdly, the Poona Pact highlighted Dr. B.R. Ambedkar's leadership and his strategic approach to securing rights for the oppressed. Ambedkar's willingness to negotiate and his pragmatic approach in the face of intense pressure showcased his dedication to the cause of social justice and his ability to navigate complex political landscapes. This event significantly raised Ambedkar's profile as a leader and advocate for the marginalized, cementing his legacy in Indian history. Lastly, the Poona Pact demonstrated the dynamic nature of India's independence movement, where social justice issues were deeply intertwined with the struggle for political freedom. It reflected the broader ideological debates within the movement, emphasizing that the fight for independence was not just against colonial rule, but also against internal social hierarchies and injustices. This book aims to provide a comprehensive and detailed analysis of the Poona Pact, exploring its historical context, terms, immediate and long-term impacts, and its significance in the broader Indian socio-political landscape. The specific objectives of the book are as follows. To provide a historical background, the book will delve into the socio-political environment of pre-independence India, examining the caste system, the rise of social reform movements, and the political landscape leading up to the Poona Pact. This will include a detailed look at the Simon Commission, the Roundtable Conferences, and the Communal Award, providing readers with a thorough understanding of the events and ideologies that shaped the pact. To analyze the negotiation process, an in-depth analysis of the negotiations between Gandhi and Ambedkar will be presented, highlighting the key points of contention, the arguments put forth by each side, and the eventual compromise. The book will explore the roles of other key figures involved in the negotiations and the dynamics of the discussions that led to the final agreement. To examine the terms and provisions of the Poona Pact, the book will provide a detailed breakdown of the terms of the pact, explaining the reserved seats, joint electorates, provisions for fair representation in public services, and economic development initiatives. Each provision will be examined in the context of its intended and actual impact on the socio-political landscape of India. To evaluate the impact and legacy of the Poona Pact, the immediate effects of the Poona Pact on the depressed classes, the nationalist movement, and the broader Indian society will be analyzed. The book will also assess the long-term implications of the pact, particularly its influence on the development of the reservation system and its role in shaping contemporary social justice policies in India. To provide a comparative analysis, the book will compare the Poona Pact with other social and political agreements, both within India and globally. This comparative analysis will highlight the unique aspects of the Poona Pact and draw lessons for contemporary social justice movements. To foster a deeper understanding of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar's vision, by examining Ambedkar's role in the Poona Pact and his broader contributions to the fight for social justice, the book aims to provide a nuanced understanding of his vision for an inclusive and egalitarian India. It will explore how Ambedkar's ideas have continued to influence social and political thought in India and beyond. Through these objectives, this book seeks to offer a comprehensive and scholarly exploration of the Poona Pact, providing valuable insights for students, researchers, and anyone interested in the history and future of social justice in India. End of the chapter. Chapter 1. The Historical Context of the Poona Pact. The early 20th century was a period of profound transformation and upheaval in India, setting the stage for crucial social and political changes. The British Raj, which began in 1858, introduced modern infrastructure and legal frameworks, but also disrupted traditional social structures and local economies. This era saw the rise of political movements striving for self-governance and social reform, highlighted by the efforts of the Indian National Congress and leaders like Bal Gangadhar Tilak and Mahatma Gandhi. Amidst this backdrop, the deeply entrenched caste system continued to perpetuate significant social inequalities. The plight of the Dalits, who faced severe discrimination and exclusion, became a focal point for social reformers. Movements led by figures such as Jyotirao Phule, Swami Vivekananda, Sri Narayana Guru, Periyar E.V. Ramasamy, and Dr. B.R. Ambedkar sought to address these injustices and advocate for the rights of the marginalized. These early reform efforts set the stage for significant agreements like the Poona Pact, which emerged from a complex interplay of political negotiations and social reform initiatives. Understanding the historical context of this period is crucial for appreciating the transformative impact of the Poona Pact on India's journey towards social justice and equality. Pre-independence India, social and political landscape. In the early 20th century, India was a nation undergoing significant upheaval and transformation. The British Raj, which began in 1858, had ushered in a new era marked by profound changes across the Indian subcontinent. While the colonial administration introduced modern infrastructure, education systems, and legal frameworks, these advancements often disrupted traditional social structures and local economies. Politically, the Indian National Congress, INC, founded in 1885, became the primary platform for Indian aspirations for self-governance. Leaders such as Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Bipin Chandra Pal, and Lala Lajpat Rai, collectively known as the Lal Bal Pal Triumvirate, fervently advocated for Swaraj self-rule. Their efforts were complemented by moderate leaders like Dadabhai Nauroji and Gopal Krishna Gokhale, who sought reform through constitutional means. The 1920s marked a transformative period in Indian politics due to Mahatma Gandhi's nonviolent resistance and mass mobilization campaigns. His methods of satyagraha, truth force, and non-cooperation united millions in the struggle against British rule. However, this era also saw the rise of communal tensions between Hindus and Muslims, exacerbated by the British policy of divide and rule.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.